My name is Julia, and in this video, we are going to talk about segments. Season after season, we sort and filter our wardrobes. Here is the drawer with all our outerwear. On this side of the closet hang all our winter coats, and on this shelf is all of our beachwear. Most of us put an effort in organizing our clothes into segments season after season because it saves us time. Depending on the occasion, we reach for the segment, instantly view the pieces, and pick an outfit in no time. It's an organized approach that simplifies the complexity of our lifestyle and ensures that we dress our best. Similarly, organizations use segmentation to know their customer base in the best conceivable way. Knowing the customers is easier said than done, but it's what makes all the difference in how effective your campaigns are. Knowing the customer can help efficiently tailor your marketing paraphernalia, product information, offers, and incentives. This makes customer analytics a crucial step in the marketing function of any organization. We analyze the customers to better understand their needs, but it can be an extremely complicated process. This umbrella concept shelters a wide range of characteristics, behaviors, and numerous other performance indicators that the business may be interested in. A marketing framework consists of segmentation, targeting, and positioning to learn as much as possible about the customer to increase sales. Segmentation focuses on dividing a population into separate groups based on similar characteristics. This assumes that these groups will have comparable purchasing behaviors. Each segment is expected to respond differently to similar marketing activities. For example, two friends, Josh and Sam, may not like the same brand of ice cream. Furthermore, it is probable that they may not be able to afford the same brand of ice cream. So, in this case, even though Josh and Sam are friends, they will be categorized into two different segments. Segments can be created based on age, income, location, gender, and many other factors. All the customers are divided into segments where each group prefers a certain flavor of ice cream. Marketers may learn that people not only share the same taste and similar income level in a particular segment, but also respond to different marketing approaches in the same way. Likewise, different segments may respond differently to the same marketing activities. Marketers usually segment their customers into two broad groups. The first is consumer data, which is inclusive of age, education, income, and planned or impulsive behavior. If you are in the product development phase, it is possible that you do not have existing consumer data. That is when it may be useful to rely on the segment of consumer data. The second segment is characteristics and is tapped into when there is existing data for a consumer's behavior. For instance, historic data, purchase frequency, time of purchase, and purchase quantity. This kind of in-depth information can be useful in creating more representative segments. Segmenting is a very powerful way to organize the customer base and precedes targeting efforts in the marketing machine, which is why it is essential to get it right. Let us know in the comments about how you segment your customer base and the ways in which it has impacted you. Give us a like if you found this useful and subscribe to our channel for more videos. Thank you for watching.
Data Science Dojo. Data science for everyone.